Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject gas power cycles. And this is lecture number 7. The topic is problems in the auto cycle. In the earlier lecture, we solved a few problems from the Anna University question paper. So this lecture also, we take few more problems on the auto cycle from Anna University question paper and solve it. The learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems on in the auto cycle. Example number 7 from November 2010 question paper. An engine working on auto cycle in which the salient points are 1, 2, 3 and 4 has upper and the lower temperature limits of T3 and T1. So T3 is the upper temperature limit and T1 is the lower temperature limit. If the maximum work per kg of air is to be done, then show that the intermediate temperature is given by T2 equal to T4 equal to T1 T3 to the power 1 by 2. That is square root of T1 T3. If an engine works on auto cycle between the temperature limits of 1430 Kelvin and 300 Kelvin, find the maximum theoretical power developed by the engine, assuming the circulation of air per minute is 0.4 kg. And the given data, T3 equal to 1430 Kelvin and T1 is 300 Kelvin. So T3 is the maximum temperature, T1 is the minimum temperature. The mass is 0.4 kg per minute. The work output during the auto cycle. So the W equal to heat supplied per cycle minus heat rejected per cycle. So MCV, so heat supplied and heat rejected both at the constant volume in the auto cycle. So MCV into T3 minus T2 minus MCV into T4 minus T1. So we combine MCV into T4 minus T1. Minus T3 plus T1. That is the amount of work done. Now this equation we may rewrite. So T3, T4 in terms of T3 and the compression ratio. So T4 equal to T3 by R to the power gamma minus 1. And T2 is T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1 from the adiabatic compression process. So T4 equal to T3 by R to the power gamma minus 1 from adiabatic expansion process, and for adiabatic compression process T2 equal to T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1, where R is the compression ratio. We take the same equation again. So MCV into T3 minus T3 by R to the power gamma minus 1 minus T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1 plus T1, and this equation we rewrite as MCV into T3 minus T3 into R to the power minus gamma plus 1 minus T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1 plus T1. Now for the maximum work done, the equation is to be differentiated with respect to the compression ratio and equal to 0. So differentiating this equation with respect to compression ratio. So MCV, so T3 is a constant, so that is cancelled, 0. And the second term, minus T3 into minus gamma plus 1 into R to the power minus gamma plus 1 minus 1 minus T1 into gamma minus 1 into R to the power gamma minus 1 minus 1, and T1 is a constant, that becomes 0. Differentially that becomes 0 and equal into 0. And the MCV, so entire term multiplied by MCV, that becomes MCV is taken to the right side, that becomes 0. So the two terms are minus T3 into minus of minus gamma plus 1 into R to the power minus gamma plus 1 minus 1, that is equal to this T1 is taken to the right side. So T1 into R to the gamma minus 1 into R to the power minus gamma minus 1 minus 1. So combining, so this minus gamma is taken out. So minus minus, it becomes plus T3 into, this becomes gamma minus 1 into R to the power gamma, R to the power minus gamma, equal to T1 into gamma minus 1 R to the power minus 2. So gamma minus 1 on both sides getting cancelled. So T3 into R to the power minus gamma equal to T1 into R to the power gamma minus 2 and T3 by T1. So, rearranging T3 by T1 equal to this r to the power minus gamma is taken to the other side. That becomes r to the power plus gamma. So, r to the power minus 2 plus gamma. Gamma minus 2 plus gamma. That becomes r to the power 2 into gamma minus 1. So, the optimum pressure ratio, that is equal to T3 by T1 to the power 1 by 2 into gamma minus 1. That is the optimum pressure ratio for maximum work output. So, this derivation is important. So, from that derivation, we will develop the another condition. We take the T2 for the compression process. T2 equal to T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. So, T1 into T3 by T1. So, RP we have already derived. So, this equation T3 by T1 into e to the power 1 by 2 into gamma minus 1. We substitute here T3 by T1 to the power gamma minus 1 by 2 into gamma minus 1. So, gamma minus 1 getting cancelled. We will get T1 into T3 by T1 to the power 1 by 2. So, simplifying this. So, T1. So, here we have T1 to the power 1. T denominator T1 to the power 1 by 2. So, this becomes square root of T1, T3. Similarly, T4 equal to T3 into R to the power minus of gamma minus 1. Now, you substitute for T3, substitute for R value, T3 into T3 by T1 to the power minus gamma minus 1 divided by 2 into gamma minus 1. That becomes T3 by T1 to the power minus 1 by 2. That is equal to, we take the reverse, T3 into T1 by T3 to the power 1 by 2. So, once again, T3 and T3 is getting cancelled. We will get square root of T1, T3. So, finally, T1, T4, T2 equal to T4 equal to square root of T1, T3. That is the condition. That is the derivation asked in the question. So, we proved that T1, intermediate temperature, T1 equal to T4 equal to square root of T1 and T3. Now, the maximum efficiency. So, maximum efficiency, eta maximum equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. So, we substitute for R value from the optimum value. So, 1 minus 1 by T3 by T1 to the power gamma minus 1 by 2 into gamma minus 1. That is equal to 1 minus square root of T1 by T3 or equal to the maximum efficiency of auto cycle equal to 1 minus square root of T minimum by T maximum. So, this equation is very important for any competitive examination. So, for competitive examinations, they will give the minimum temperature and the maximum temperature, and they will ask you to calculate the maximum efficiency of the cycle. So, this is how to remember. Eta maximum equal to 1 minus square root of T minimum by T maximum. And this equation is very much applicable to Brayton cycle also. And the work output. So, we go back to the original equation. Work output we calculate per unit mass. Cv into T3 minus T4 minus Cv into T2 minus T1. That becomes Cv into T3 minus T4 minus T2 plus T1. Now, we substitute for T1, T2 and T4. So, we substitute MCV into T3 into T3 by R to the power gamma minus 1 minus T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1 plus 1 plus T1. And this equation we are very much familiar. So, we are rewriting this equation MCV into T3 minus T3 into R to the power minus gamma plus 1 minus T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. Plus T1. Now, we substitute for R from the optimum value. R equal to T3 by T1 to the power 1 by 2 into gamma minus 1. So, MCV as it is, T3 it is retained. So, now T3 into substituting for R to the power minus gamma plus 1. So, T3 by T1 to the power minus gamma plus 1 divided by 2 into gamma minus 1 minus T1 into T3 by T1 to the power gamma minus 1 by 2 into gamma minus 1 plus T1. Now, look at the conclusion. So, T3, it is there. This becomes minus 1 by 2. So, T3 into T3 by T1 to the power minus 1 by 2 minus T1 into T3 by T1 to the power 1 by 2 plus 1 plus T1. And this, as we said earlier, this becomes square root of T1, T3. And the second term becomes square root of T1, T3. Now, this becomes T3. Minus square root of T1, T3 minus square root of T1, T3 plus T1. So, this is T3 minus 2 times of square root of T1, T3 plus T1. So, this becomes square root of T3 minus square root of T1 whole square into M into CV. That is the work maximum, work output from the cycle. So this equation also important for competitive examination. The maximum work output equal to MCV into square root of T3 minus square root of T1 whole square. Now using this equation, we are going to calculate the work output. So the maximum theoretical power equal to MCV into square root of T3 minus square root of T1 whole square. So T3 is the maximum temperature 1430 and T1 is the minimum temperature 300 square root of 300 whole square. This becomes 120.63 kilojoules per minute or 2.01 kilojoules per second or kilowatts. So the maximum theoretical power is 2.01 kilowatts. That is the answer. So the derivation we have to remember. T2 equal to T4 equal to square root of T1 T3, and the maximum work output you should have to remember MCV into square root of T3 minus square root of T1 whole square. The next problem, example number 8 from the November 2012 question paper. A spark ignition engine working on ideal Otto cycle has a compression ratio 6. The initial pressure and temperature of the air are 1 bar and 37 degrees Celsius. The maximum pressure in the cycle is 30 bar. For unit mass flow, calculate pressure, volume and temperature at the various salient points of the cycle and the ratio of heat supplied to the heat rejected. Assume gamma equal to 1.4, RO, universal gas constant, equal to 8.314 kilojoules per kilogram mole Kelvin. And this is from November 2012 question paper. And we write down the given data. R equal to 6, compression ratio equal to 6, P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 37 degrees Celsius, which is 310 Kelvin, P3 equal to 30 bar, and gamma equal to 1.4. And we calculate the gas constant from the universal gas constant. We calculate the gas constant. So, gas constant equal to universal gas constant divided by the molecular weight of air. Molecular weight of air is 28.97. So, 8.314 divided by 28.97 equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And the specific volume we calculate. So, the specific volume before the compression and specific volume after the compression. So, V1 equal to RT1 by P1. So, which is 0.281 into 310 divided by 100 equal to 0.8897 meter cube per kilogram. And the V2 from the compression ratio, we calculate the specific volume after the compression. So, V2 equal to small V1 specific volume at initial specific volume divided by R. So, 0.8897 divided by 6 equal to 0.1483. And we know for the Otto cycle, V1 equal to V4 and V2 equal to V3. And look at here, V2 equal to V3 and V1 equal to V4. Now, we take the isentropic compression process. So, we calculate the P2 and T2 for the isentropic compression process. So, P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma. So, V1 by V2 equal to R. So, 1 into 6 to the power 1.4. P1 equal to 1 bar. So, 6 to the power 1.4 equal to 12.286 bar. And T2 is T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1. So, where V1 by V2 equal to R to R. So, 310 into 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 634.8 Kelvin. Now, for constant volume heat addition process, so we are given the maximum pressure of the cycle 30 bar. So, T3 we calculate, T3 equal T2 into P3 by P2. So, 634.8 into 30 divided by 12.286 equal to 1550 Kelvin. And the specific heat at constant volume, so we have Cp minus Cv equal to R. So, equal to, we take Cv outside. So, Cv into Cp by Cv minus 1 equal to Cv into Cp by Cv is gamma. So, Cv into gamma minus 1 equal to R. So, Cv equal to R by gamma minus 1. So, the basic equation, when you are comfortable with the basic equation, you can derive whatever is required. So, Cv equal to R by gamma minus 1. So, 0.287 divided by 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.7175 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And for isentropic expansion process, we calculate P4. P4 equal to P3 into V3 by V4 to the power gamma, where V3 equal to V2, V4 equal to V1. So, P3 into V2 by V1 to the power gamma, which is P3 into V2 by V1 equal to 1 by R. So, 1 by R to the power gamma. So, 30 divided by 6 to the power 1.4 equal to 2.44 bar. And T4 equal to T3 into V3 by V4 to the power gamma minus 1. A similar way, we substitute. So, T3 into 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1550 divided by 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1. So, So calculating the temperature T4 equal to 756.9 Kelvin. And the amount of heat supplied per unit mass. So QS equal to CV into T3 minus T2. So 0.7175 into 1550 minus 634.8 equal to 656.656 kilojoules per kilogram. And the heat rejected QR equal to CV into T4 minus T1, which is equal to 0.7175 into 756.9 minus 310 equal to 320.65 kilojoules per kilogram. And the ratio of heat supplied to the heat rejected, so QS by QR equal to 656.656 divided by 320.65 equal to 2.05. QS by QR equal to 2.05. So the answer to the problem, the pressure, volume and temperature at the end of each process of the cycle, P in bar, pressure in bar, temperature in Kelvin and the volume in meter cube per kilogram. So pressure P1 equal to 1 bar, P2 equal to 12.286 bar, P3 equal to 30 bar and P4 equal to 2.44 bar. Temperature T1 equal to 310 Kelvin, T2 equal to 634.8 Kelvin and T3 equal to 1550 Kelvin and T4 equal to 756.9 Kelvin. And the volume in meter cube per kilogram, so V1 equal to 0.8897 meter cube per kilogram, V2 equal to 0.1483 and V2 equal to V3 equal to 0.1483 and V4 equal to V1 0.8897. And the ratio of heat supplied to the heat rejected is 2.05. The next problem from the November 2013 question paper. An auto cycle has a compression ratio of 7. The initial pressure and temperature at the beginning of the compression stroke is 1 bar and 40 degrees Celsius. The heat supplied is 2510 kilojoules per kilogram. Find the maximum temperature and the pressure, work done per kg of air, the cycle efficiency, mean effective pressure. So take CV equal to 0.713 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And we write down the given data, R, compression ratio R equal to V1 by V2 equal to 7, P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 40 degrees Celsius, which is 313 Kelvin, QS equal to 2510 kilojoules per kilogram, CV equal to 0.717 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and R, gas constant R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And we calculate the specific heat ratio, gamma value from the given CV and R. So, we know gamma equal to 1 plus R by CV. So, this equal to 1 plus 287 divided by 713 equal to 1.4. And we calculate the initial specific volume. So, V1 equal to RT1 by P1, which is equal to 0.287 into 313 divided by 100 equal to 0.8983 meter cube per kilogram. And the PV diagram of the auto cycle is shown here. 1 to 2 isentropic compression. 2 to 3 constant volume heat addition, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion process and 4 to 1 constant volume heat rejection. So for the process, first process isentropic compression process, P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma. So 1 into 7 to the power 1.4 equal to 15.24 bar and T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, which is 313 into 7 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 681.7 Kelvin. So P2 equal to 15.24 bar and T2 equal to 681.7 Kelvin. And for constant volume heat addition process, we have to calculate the maximum temperature and the pressure. So QS equal to CV into T3 minus T2, the heat addition at constant volume. So from this equation, we calculated T3. So T3 equal to T2 into Q by CV, which is 681.7. plus 2510 divided by 0.713 equal to 4202 Kelvin and P3 equal to P2 into T3 by T2 for constant volume process. So 15.24 into 4202 divided by 681.7 equal to 93.94 bar. Then the cycle efficiency is eta equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. So this equal to 1 minus 1 by 7 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.541, which is 54.1%. And we calculate the work done. So work done W equal to eta into QS, so which is 0.541 into 2510 equal to 1357.91 kilojoules per kilogram. And the mean effective pressure we calculate net work output divided by the swept volume. So W divided by V1 minus V2. So in the denominator, we take V1 outside. This become 1 minus V2 by V1, which is 1 minus 1 by R. So substitute the numerical values, 1357.1 divided by 0.8983 into 1 minus 1 by 7. So calculating the mean effective pressure is 1633.1 kilopascal. So the answer to the problem, the maximum temperature and the pressure of the cycle, 4202 Kelvin and 93.94 bar. Work done per kg of the air, 1357.191 kilojoules per kilogram. The cycle efficiency is 54.1% and the mean effective pressure is 1633.1 kilopascal. Next question from the November 2014 question paper, example number 10, an engine works on auto cycle. The initial pressure and the temperature of the air is 1 bar and 40 degrees Celsius. 825 kilojoules per kg of heat is supplied to the air at the end of the compression. Find the temperature and the pressure at all the salient points if the compression ratio is 6. Also find the efficiency and mean effective pressure for the cycle. Assume the air is used as a working fluid and take all ideal conditions. So we write down the given data. So the initial given pressure P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 40 degrees Celsius, which is 313 Kelvin. Heat supplied equal to 825 kilojoules per kilogram. The compression ratio R equal to 6. And taking ideal conditions, gamma equal to 1.4. CV equal to specific heat at constant volume. CV equal to 0.718 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And the R value equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And we calculate the specific volume at initially and finally. So the before the compression and the after the compression. So the V1 equal to RT1 by P1 from the perfect gas equation. So substituting the values 0.287 into 313 divided by 100 equal to 0.8983 meter cube per kilogram. And the V2 equal to V1 by R. So 0.8983 divided by 6 is this equal to 1497 meter cube per kilogram. And we take the pressure volume diagram of the auto cycle, 1 to 2 isentropic compression process, 2 to 3 constant volume heat addition, and 3 to 4 isentropic expansion, and 4 to 1 the constant volume heat rejection. So for the isentropic compression process, so P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma, so V1 by V2 equal to R, so 1 into 6 to the power 1.4 equal to 12.286 bar, and T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, so which is 313 into 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 640.9 Kelvin. And for constant volume heat addition process, now the equation, heat addition equation QS equal to CV into T3 minus T2. So rearrange the terms to calculate T3, the maximum temperature, T3 equal to T2 plus Q by CV. So 640.9 plus 825 divided by 0.718 equal to 1789.9 Kelvin. And the maximum pressure P3 equal to P2 into T3 by T2, which is 12.286 into 1789.9 divided by 640.9 equal to 34.31 bar. Now for the isentropic expansion process, so P4 equal to P3 into V4 by V3 by V4 to the power gamma. We know V3 equal to V2, V4 equal to V1. So this P3 into V2 by V1 to the power gamma. And this equal to 1 by R, so P3 into 1 by R to the power gamma, 34.31 divided by 6 to the power 1.4 equal to 2.79 bar. And the temperature T4 equal to T3 into V3 by V4 to the power gamma minus 1. And we know V3 equal to V2 and V4 equal to V1, so T3 into V2 by V1 to the power gamma minus 1. So this equal to T3 into 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1789.9 divided by 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 874.1 Kelvin. We calculate the cycle efficiency, eta equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. So 1 minus 1 by 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.512. So 51.2%. Then the work done eta, W equal to eta into QS. So 0.512 into 825 equal to 422.4 kilojoules per kilogram. And the mean effective pressure, we calculate net work output divided by the swept volume. So W divided by V1 minus V2. So 422.4 divided by 0.8983. minus 0.1497 equal to 564.2 kilopascal. So we consulted the answer to the problem. The pressure and temperature at the end of each process of the cycle, pressure in bar, temperature in Kelvin. So P1 equal to 1 bar, P2 equal to 12.286 bar, P3 equal to 34.31 bar, and P4 equal to 2.79 bar. Temperature T1 equal to 313 Kelvin, T2 equal to 640.9 Kelvin, T3 equal to 1789.9 Kelvin, and T4 equal to 874.1 Kelvin. The cycle efficiency is 51.2% and the mean effective pressure is 564.2 kilopascal. The next example number 11 from November 2017 and May 2019 question paper. A gas engine operating on ideal Otto cycle has a compression ratio of 6:1. The pressure and temperature at the commencement of the compression process are 1 bar and 27 degrees Celsius. The heat added during the constant volume combustion process is 1170 kilojoules per kilogram. Determine the peak pressure, temperature and temperature, work output per kg of air and air standard efficiency. Assume Cp equal to 1.004 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and Cv equal to 0.717 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin for the air. We write down the given data. R equal to 6, compression ratio equal to 6, P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, which is equal to 300 Kelvin, and the QS equal to 1170 kilojoules per kilogram, Cp equal to 1.004, Cv equal to 0.717 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and gamma we calculate equal to Cp by Cv equal to 1.4. And this is the pressure volume diagram of the Otto cycle. So 1 to 2 isentropic compression, 2 to 3 constant volume heat addition, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion and 4 to 1 constant volume heat rejection. And we calculate for the isentropic compression process, P2 equal to P1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. So V1 by V2 equal to R to R, so R to the power gamma. So 1 into 6 to the power 1.4 equal to 12.286 bar. And T2 equal to T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. So 300 into 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 614.3 Kelvin. And the from constant volume heat addition process, so QS equal to Cv into T3 minus T2. So from this equation, we calculate T3 equal to T2 plus Q by Cv equal to 614.3 plus 1170 divided by 0.717 equal to 2246.1 Kelvin. And the P3 equal to maximum pressure, P3 equal to P2 into T3 by T2. So 12.286 into 2246.1 divided by 614.3 equal to 44.92 bar. And the air standard efficiency, eta equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. So 1 minus 1 by 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.512 equal to 51.2%. And the work done for the cycle, eta into QS, which is 0.512 into QS equal to 1170 equal to 599 kilojoules per kilogram. And we consulted the result. The peak pressure and temperature P3 equal to 44.92 bar and T3 equal to 2246.1 Kelvin. Work output per cycle per kg of the air equal to 599 kilojoules per kilogram and the air standard efficiency is 51.2%. The next question from May 2018 question paper, example number 12. In an Otto cycle, air at 17 degrees Celsius and 1 bar is compressed adiabatically until the pressure is 15 bar. Heat is added at constant volume until the pressure rises to 40 bar. Calculate the air standard efficiency, compression ratio, mean effective pressure of the cycle. Assume Cv equal to 0.717 and RO, universal gas constant, RO equal to 8.314 kilojoules per kilogram mole Kelvin. So we write down the given data. T1 equal to 17 degrees Celsius, which is 290 Kelvin, P1 equal to 1 bar, P2 equal to 15 bar, and P3 equal to 40 bar, Cv equal to 0.717 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and RO equal to 8.314 kilojoules per kilogram mole Kelvin. And we calculate the gas constant for air. So R equal to RO by molecular weight of air. So 8.314 divided by 28.97 equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And we calculate the specific heat ratio, gamma equal to 1 plus R by Cv. So 1 plus 287 divided by 717 equal to 1.4, and we calculate the pressure ratio Rp equal to P3 by P2, which is 40 by 15 equal to 2.67. Now we take the compression, we calculate the compression ratio. Compression ratio R equal to V1 by V2, which is P2 by P1 to the power 1 by gamma. So 15 divided by 1 to the power 1 by 1.4 equal to 6.92. That is the compression ratio for the Otto cycle. And the air standard efficiency eta equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 6.92 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.5387 or 53.87%. The mean effective pressure, we take the equation, mean effective pressure equal to net work output divided by the swept volume. So P1 into R into Rp minus 1 into R to the power gamma minus 1 minus 1 divided by gamma minus 1 into R minus 1. So substituting numerical values, 1 into P1 equal to 1 bar. So 1 into 6.92 into 2.67 minus 1 into 6.92 to the power 1.4 minus 1 minus 1 divided by 1.4 minus 1 into 6.92 minus 1 equal to 5.7 bar. So the answer to the problem, compression ratio is 6.92, air standard efficiency is 53.87% and mean effective pressure is 5.7 bar. The next question from November 2019 question paper, example number 13, in an SI engine working on auto cycle, the compression ratio is 5.5. The pressure and temperature of compression are 1 bar and 27 degrees Celsius respectively. The peak pressure is 30 bar. Determine the pressure and temperature at all the salient points, air standard efficiency, mean effective pressure. Assume the specific heat ratio as 1.4 for air. So we write down the given data. R equal to 5.5. Pressure P1 equal to 1 bar. Temperature T1 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin. Pressure P3, maximum pressure P3 equal to 30 bar and gamma equal to 1.4 for air. And we take the PV diagram. So for the Otto cycle, 1 to 2 isentropic compression process, 2 to 3 constant volume heat addition, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion process and 4 to 1 constant volume heat rejection. We calculate the For isentropic compression process, we calculate the pressure and temperature. P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2, which is P1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. So 1 into 5.5 to the power 1.4 equal to 10.88 bar. And T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2, which is R. So T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. So 300 into 5.5 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 593.3 Kelvin. For constant volume heat addition, we have T3 equal to T2 into P3 by P2, which is 593.3 into 30 by 10.88 equal to 1635.9 Kelvin. And for isentropic expansion process, so we have P4 equal to P3 into V3 by V4 to the power gamma, where V3 equal to V2, V4 equal to V1. So P3 into V2 by V1 to the power gamma, and this V2 by V1 equal to 1 by R. So P3 into 1 by R to the power gamma equal to 30 divided by 5.5 to the power 1.4 equal to 2.76 bar. And similarly, T4 equal to T3 into V3 by V4 to the power gamma minus 1. So T3 into V3 equal to V2, V4 equal to V1. So this V2 by V1 equal to 1 by R. So T3 into 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. So this is 1635.9 divided by 5.5 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 827.2 Kelvin. So the cycle efficiency is eta equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 5.5 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.4943 or 49.43%. We calculate the heat supplied for the cycle. So QS equal to CV into T3 minus T2. So 0.718 into 1635.9 minus 593.3 equal to 748.6 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate the work done from the equation, eta, work done equal to eta into heat supplied. So 0.4943 into 748.6 equal to 370 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific volume V1, V2 we calculate. V1 equal to RT1 by P1, which is 0.287 into 300 divided by 100 equal to 0.861 meter cube per kilogram. and V2 from the compression ratio, V2 equal to V1 by R equal to 0.861 divided by 5.5 equal to 0.1565 meter cube per kilogram. And the mean effective pressure we calculate. So, mean effective pressure equal to net work output divided by the swept volume. So, W divided by V1 minus V2, which is 370. Substitute the numerical values, 370 divided by 0.861 minus 0.1565 equal to 525.2 kilopascal. So, we write down the answer to the problem. The pressure and temperature at the end of each process of the cycle. Pressure in bar, temperature in Kelvin. So, P1 equal to 1 bar, P2 equal to 10.88 bar, P3 equal to 30 bar and P4 equal to 2.76 bar. Temperature T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, T2 equal to 593.3 Kelvin, T3 equal to 1635.9 Kelvin and T4 equal to 827.2 Kelvin. The cycle efficiency is 49.43% and the mean effective pressure is 525.2 kilopascal. And we stop here. So, we solved totally 13 problems in the Otto cycle. Majority of the problem, the questions were similar. We have to calculate the pressure temperature at all salient points of the cycle. We have to calculate the efficiency. We have to calculate the mean effective pressure. And one thing you have to be very clear. You have to very thoroughly know the equation and the pressure volume diagram. And mean effective pressure you can calculate by different methodology. Knowing the equation, if you remember the equation for mean effective pressure, that is well and good. Otherwise, you have to calculate the swept volume. Mean effective pressure equal to work done divided by the swept volume. So, from the given information, in a easiest way, you have to calculate the parameter. So, for that, you should be confident, you should be thorough with the equations for the Otto cycle. Then you can solve the problem easily. And you can refer to these books for additional information. I have published a book on thermal engineering. And in addition to that, we can refer to Engineering Thermodynamics by P.K. Nag, Thermodynamics by Senjal and Bowles, Engineering Thermodynamics by Rajput or Thermal Engineering by Bellani. That will give additional information or additional problems in the Otto cycle. I conclude the lecture with a quote from Dr. Abdul Kalam. Dream is not which you see while sleeping. It is something that does not let you sleep. So, you work hard so that you will be successful in your life. And these are all the books I published earlier. So, design of transmission system, turbomachines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subject and the solution for gate question paper in the YouTube channel. It is absolutely free for the mechanic all for all the students. So, this will help the mechanical engineering student. Please subscribe the channel and use the video for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination. Thank you for watching. You can please post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube video and you can subscribe the channel and you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. I will sincerely answer. We will meet you in the next video lecture with additional problems in the diesel cycle.